Requirement elicitation techniques. So how to gather all these requirements? So in this video, we're going to discuss on that. Requirements elicitation is a process to find out the requirements for an intended software system. That means the software system which is intended, that means which is going to get developed. And from where you are going to gather all these requirements from the stakeholders, that means who are involved in this particular project. So by communicating with the client, end users, system users and others who have a stake in the software system development. So from them, we are supposed to gather all these requirements. So there are various ways to discover these requirements. So now we are going to discuss some of them, the major ways. The first one we are going to discuss is the interviews. So interviews are strong medium to collect requirements. Organization may conduct several types of interviews. So some of them are structured or closed interviews where every single information to gather is decided in advance and they follow a pattern and matter to discussion, to have the discussion formally. Next one is the non-structured. So in case of structured, we know that what are the information you are supposed to gather. So we are having that particular list and through this interview we are gathering all this information. So next one is the non-structured or open interviews where information to gather is not decided in advance and more flexible and less biased. So that is another way to gather our information through interviews. So another one is the oral interviews. Next, written interviews. One-to-one interviews which are held between two persons across the table, then group interviews which are held between groups of participants, they help to uncover their missing requirements as numerous people are involved. So we can go for one-to-one meeting, we can go for group discussion, we can have the written interviews, we're having the oral interviews, so multiple different ways to conduct such interviews. So next one is the surveys. So organization may conduct surveys among various stakeholders by querying about their expectation and requirements from the upcoming going to be developed system. Next one is the questionnaire. A document with predefined set of objective questions and respective options are handed over to the all stakeholders to answer them and which are collected and then it will get compiled to get the ultimate requirement list. A shortcoming of this technique is that if an opinion for some issue is not mentioned in the questionnaire, the issue might be left unattended. So this is the one of the shortcomings we are having. So making the questionnaire is a big challenge. Here we should cover all the expected requirements. So now we are having the task analysis. So team of engineering and developers may analyze the operation for which the new system is required. So this new system will have which kind of functionalities, what are the tasks to be implemented. So from there we can also generate our requirement list. If the client already has some software to perform certain operations, it is studied and requirements of the proposed systems are getting constructed, are getting collected. Domain analysis. So every software falls into some domain category. The expert people in the domain can be a great help to analyze general and some specific requirements. So depending upon the domain in which the software will be working, so we are having some prior experience, prior idea, if we have conducted such projects earlier in that very respective domain, then from there we can easily collect all the requirements there. Next one is the brainstorming. If an informal debate is held among various stakeholders and all their inputs are recorded for further requirement analysis. So that is one of the methods is known as brainstorming. So in this way, we have discussed what are the main ways, the main means to calculate or say to collect these requirements from the stakeholders. Next one is the prototyping. Prototyping is building user interface without adding detailed functionality for user to interpret the features of intended software product. So in case of prototype, we are just making the miniature version of the software. where the main functionalities are getting implemented, not the all functionalities. It is not the full version of the software. So that's prototype, that's the minimum or the miniature version of the software can be developed. It helps giving better idea of requirements. So if there is no software installed at the client's end for developer's reference and the client is not aware of its own requirements, the developer creates a prototype based on initially mentioned requirements. The prototype is shown to the client and the feedback is noted. The client feedback serves as an input for the requirement gathering. If the client is not having such software preloaded on the system, so from here we can start our discussion. In that case, we can develop one prototype software in the domain in which the software is going to be developed. And on this particular prototype, we can have a discussion after giving the demonstration to the client. We can get the feedback from the client. What are the add-on features the client is actually demanding? What are the other features the client is want to deduct from the existing prototype? So in this way, we can have a communication in between the client and respective developing team, so that ultimately the requirement list will get confirmed and it can be formed. Observation: a team of experts visit the client's organization or workplace. They observe the actual working of the existing installed systems. They observe the workflow at the client's end and how execution problems are dealt. The team itself draws some conclusion which aid to form the requirement expected from the software, for the software. So now in this case, you see, this is known as the observation. So the respective development team will be visiting the client site, and if there are some existing softwares are there on the client machine, so they will observe how the client is interacting with the softwares and what are the difficulties they are facing. So that's why they are going for the new software development. And if the client is not having any pre-installed software, so they might be doing the job in some manual way. So they also observe that how these manual processes are getting carried out one after another. So from there, they will have a communication with the client and they will make one requirement list. So here in this particular flowchart, we have discussed that how this elicitation of requirements can be done. So elicit requirements. So that is the starting state and that is the final state. So if you consider this one as the activity diagram, so it is activity diagram you can consider. Otherwise, you can just consider this one as a flow chart, but it is not a flow chart because flow chart does not have such initial state and final state. So let us consider this one as the activity diagram. So this elicit requirements, this particular process has got elaborately demonstrated. This one has got elaborately demonstrated here. So in this way, we are having this, say it is version 1.0, it is a version, say 2.0, and it is having the version for this one, for say another version for this. So now this one has got elaborately explained here. So conduct meetings, make lists of functions and classes, make lists of constraints, etc. Then formal prioritization. Yes or no? If it is yes, the use QFD to prioritize the requirements. So informally prioritize the requirements if the priorities are not suggested by the client or not has been decided. Then create use cases. What is the use case? You can go for our UML tutorial which I have presented there. So you can also know that what is the use case. So use case, this particular word use case means the functional requirements. So for each and every use case, one process has to be generated. So that is nothing but representing one functional requirement of the software. And that is the finishing state. So this one actually we are having. So now this is the branching. Now you create use case can have this respective flow. So define actors. So what is the actor? Who is the initiator of the use case? What is the actor? Who is the initiator of the use case? It will be known as the actor. Then write scenario and complete template. And this right scenario can be also a parallel path here. So in this way, you can have this detailing of this create use cases. So in this particular video, we have discussed that how these requirements can be elicited. So that is eliciting of our requirements in our software development process. Thanks for watching this video.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.